Hey there, this is Danny with a quick tutorial for getting started with the Habit Tracker. After you make a copy of the spreadsheet in your Google Drive account, you'll open the spreadsheet and the first thing you'll notice is that the spreadsheet is set up with tabs across the bottom, and these are how you'll navigate the spreadsheet. We'll start by clicking on the tab labeled Settings, and this tab is sort of a central command station for the entire spreadsheet. Once your information is plugged in here, it will auto-populate that information into the other areas of the spreadsheet that need it. So the first step is going to be identifying a list of habits that you want to form over the next 12 months. It's made to track up to 20 habits, so you'll just type your habits into these cells. I'll go ahead and just plug mine in here as an example. Now you can see the 20 habits that I want to work on this year. I'm a very visual person, so I like to add emojis to the beginning of each habit, but that is entirely optional. The second thing you'll do to set up the tracker is identify how frequently you want to complete each habit by putting the number of times per month into these cells that are labeled monthly. If it's going to stay the same month to month throughout the year, you can simply drag these across so that they duplicate into every column. But if it's a habit that you are going to build up slowly month by month, or perhaps it's a seasonal habit that you do more in the summer and less in the winter, you can adjust these to reflect those differences in frequency for each habit. And again, I'll just add mine quickly so you can see what that looks like. You can see that some of my habits change frequency throughout the year, some build month by month, and some stay the same. Once you have your habits and that habit frequency set up how you want it, you'll switch over to one of the monthly tabs. And you'll notice that the spreadsheet has auto-populated your habits into each monthly tracking sheet. And over here on the right, it has also auto-populated the number of times you want to complete each of those habits that month. Each column represents a day, and as you complete habits, you'll simply check them off using these checkboxes. You'll notice that as I complete more habits, the emojis down at the bottom of the column are changing. The more habits that I complete, the more the emoji changes, ultimately turning into a flame emoji if I complete 15 or more of my habits. So the emoji at the bottom is showing you your daily progress. And this is also a form of gamification that makes the habit tracker really fun to use and gives you that instant feedback and reward that helps our habits stick. But it is also tracking your monthly progress in the columns along the right. And as you make your way through the month, it'll show you a percentage toward completion. And those cells are going to change color from red to yellow to green as you progress toward your goal. Switching back to the settings tab to show you annual progress, this tab is adding up the completion of your habits across all monthly tabs and displaying your progress toward your annual goal here in column R. I love this tab, and being able to see my annual progress is so helpful if I have a rough month, get injured, or just take a long vacation. It's really nice to know that a bad day, week, or month does not make or break my ability to form new habits. And it's nice to know that you can start using this at any point throughout the year. Let's say that you want to start using it in April. All you need to do is rearrange the months. So just drag the months that have passed over to the right. So the tracker now starts in April and will go through March of the following year. So that's all you need to do to get your spreadsheet set up and ready to use. Simply identify the habits you want to work on, up to 20 of them, and then identify that habit frequency month to month on the settings tab. Overall, it should be pretty quick and simple. If you start setting up the habit tracker and you just find yourself struggling to maybe identify what habits you want to work on, or maybe you just aren't even sure what habits for hydration, nutrition, exercise, organization, or other areas of your life would actually help you feel your best and reach your goals, pop over to the course tab in the spreadsheet. This tab introduces you to my self-paced online program called The Daily Method. And if you are enrolled in the course, you can simply click on the lessons that are listed in this tab to watch short videos on 9 different topics. The Daily Method simplifies habit formation by introducing you to a couple of my favorite tools. The first is what I call HONEYs. HONEYs is an acronym that represents 6 vital areas of life. Ideally, we'd have at least a couple strong habits in each of these areas because they're all very interconnected and we need alignment between all of them to feel and perform at our best. So HONEYs stands for hydration, organization, nutrition, exercise, your why, and sleep. When you enroll in the course, you'll get access to 9 online video lessons where I'll give you brief but informative overviews of each of these topics and help you identify habits that you might want to work toward in each area to progress toward your goals. The course utilizes additional exercises contained in those additional tabs that you'll find at the bottom of the habit tracker, just to help you clarify your goals and guide you through gentle habit formation through an entire 12-month period. You'll also get access to more detailed tutorials for the habit tracker to help you set it up and customize it for various types of habits and activities. And the course includes daily support from me via the comments section on each lesson, where you can ask questions, get feedback, or request additional resources. Along with those 6 lessons focused on honeys, the course also includes an introduction to the digital organization system that I totally swear by, called the Extended Brain, which keeps my entire life organized. And if you find yourself watching this video and thinking, like, this habit tracker is awesome, but I feel so disorganized, I don't even know how I'd make the habit tracker a habit and stick to it, this part of the course is for you. I'll teach you this simple 4-part framework that creates a foundation for organizing all the key aspects of your life and work. There's also the opportunity for ongoing accountability with my monthly review days. These are hosted online from 9 to 10:30 a.m. CST on the first Monday of each month. One of the things that we do during these is check in on our habit trackers. And these aren't just fun little meetups. They can also be a really valuable form of accountability as the year progresses. These are open to all paying Substack subscribers, so there's something you can attend whether you choose to enroll in the course or not. They are a great way to stay consistent and get support for the habit tracker on a monthly basis throughout the entire year. So again, if you feel like you want to go in depth on habit formation, the method I use for digital organization, and get daily support from me as you develop your new habits, you can just pop over to the course tab to learn more or visit this URL. All right, that's all I've got, but I hope that this was helpful and that you enjoy using the habit tracker for the year ahead. If you have questions about the tracker or the course, leave them in the comments below and I'll be happy to help.